The Binghamton Crosbys present Croup's Day Out. Chapter 1, Waking Up. The Croup was in a deep slumber, suffering from many night terrors. But he finally awoke and sprung out of bed, twirling his body toward the telephone. It began to ring, so he picked it up and put it on his face. There was a strange man, so he slammed it back shut very angrily and left his room to go brush all of his teeth. Chapter 2, The Bathroom Spooker. The Croup was just contemplating flossing his gums when a weird man popped up and spooked him. He turned around cautiously. It was the Bathroom Spooker. Bah! He said, "Listen, the Croup, you don't have much time, but you need to go to Wendy's and procure a delicious burger, and you also need a bottle of duck sauce. Don't ask, but you must defeat the man in plaid. It's already time for me to go." So the Croup and the Spooker shook hands like two great, powerful men, and the Spooker went back away into the shower from whence he came. Chapter 3. After picking up the duck sauce and the Wendy's, Croup saw someone in the road. It was Ecop, and he was a badass. He sauntered over to the car. Ecop said, "Listen here, the Croup. I can't let you go through with this. It's too dangerous. I know the Spooker told you to get the duck sauce. I'll need you to hand that over to me. I can't have you getting yourself into trouble." So the Croup reached for the duck sauce, but had other plans in mind, and he knew what he must do. Chapter 4. The Croup arrived at the man in plaid's lair. "Ah! A tiger! How is he to defeat such a ferocious beast? But lo, the tiger is the least of his worries, for there is the zookeeper, along with his companion, Rain Man, and the Taco Boy." He said, "Listen, the Croup, we're three very hungry boys, so we're just gonna go ahead and eat your body." When the Croup suddenly remembered that within his jacket holds a powerful and undefeatable weapon. Using his smart brain, he distracted the three and was able to sneak himself around their backs to the door. Chapter 5. The Croup gingerly opened the door when it slammed shut behind him. He walked very slowly through the corridor and found a filled dinner table. He found a plate of Oreos and immediately reached one of his little fingers for one. He gnawed at them ever so succulently. But lo, the humble sounds of gnawing were too much and awoke the man in plaid, who was actually a terrible monster. The monster got up from his seat and snuck up behind the unknowing Croup. The Croup ran away as fast as he could, getting to the door, but the door would not budge. It would appear that this is the end for the Croup. When Ecop freaking burst through the door, he was extremely angry and said, "Listen, the Croup, it's time for us to go." But the Croup directed his attention toward the terrible monster, and the battle ensued. Throwing fist upon fist, and knee upon knee, the two warriors battled. Winning the day in the name of Ecop, our glorious victor. The final chapter. Ecop revealed to the Croup that it was him who called him that morning, and all he was trying to do was keep him safe. But he was still going to arrest him for covering him in all that disgusting duck sauce. With a couple of snaps and a yoink, Ecop taught Croup the most important lesson of all. The end.